Loop, Savannah Loop. So today I'm at Government Canyon State National Area in San Antonio. I think I'm somewhere around here. I'm trying to go up here. I should have brought my phone holder. It would make this a lot less confusing. I think this way. Trail should split up ahead and then I could go north. What they call on the map the backcountry. Let's see. Campground trailhead. I think I could get where I'm going if I go straight too. Let's see. I've never been here before. This is my first time. Definitely gotta bring my phone out the next time. Massive cobweb, like huge. It felt like I broke a fishing line. Ugh. Jeez. I would think somebody already on this trail would have broken it. When I was pulling into here, I don't have a spider on me, I saw signs that said that there's over an hour wait time to get in. They're not even being that long of a line. I'd imagine this place on the weekend fills up pretty quickly. Okay, what do we got here? I can't go through here. I had to backtrack a bit. That trail is closed. Let's try to get to where I'm trying to go through here. So anyway, it's April 22nd, I believe, and it is 72 degrees and sunny. It's a beautiful day. It's not humid, but it rained. The ground's a little bit wet. Ah, bugs keep hitting me. You gotta watch out for snakes in this kind of grass. All right, so this spits me out into the parking lot. Where do I go from here? Let's see. All right, let's see. It's only showing one trail. It looks like there's two right here. This. Can't go on the trailhead. Shoot. Recharge trail. Is this what I want? Okay, yes, I think if I go right, I can get to the trail I'm looking for, which will take me deep into the park. Look at all these flowers. All right, yes. Sendero balconies. So this is what I want to take. See how far I can make it into this place. All right. Kind of hoping this be smoother. A somewhat flat place to do it. Whoa. There we go. Lower this down. Oh my god. All right, I'm really hoping this flattens out. Push over this. better downhill. Get a second battery for this thing. All right, hold on. Let me check my map again. Yeah, forget this. I'm gonna go. There's another trail. I don't want to like destroy my bike. Make the other trail smoother. I'll also get me to the back of the park. I just sort of have to go back to where I parked. Yeah, this is way easier downhill. These rocks. So anyway, the interesting thing about this park is it's only open Friday through Monday. I went on a Monday, hoping there wouldn't be many people, and I think this was a good choice, just based on those wait time signs. Back at the fork I started at. I go straight. I think I can make a left. It's hiking only. Runner in the trail. I don't know if this will come out on camera. Hello. Hello. Thank you. Hi. So it was just a sign that 2 miles up ahead there's some sort of dinosaur footprints. Maybe we'll check those out if the trail isn't too crazy to get to them. These crazy trails are fun to ride, but then I also kind of want this bike to last. It's like pounding over these giant boulders isn't good. For it. I'm eventually gonna bend something. Even honestly on this trail, on a lot of places there's just sharp rocks embedded in the road. I don't know if that comes across on camera. Here's a smooth section. I'm on the Joe Johnston route. It's 4.45 miles. Let's see if I can get. Let's see if I can get this. To go to the dinosaur footprint. In the future, I want to get another battery. Like, even though this has decent range, I still get range anxiety. Put it on the back, swap them out. I think at that point, I won't exceed. I could get out of 2 batteries. This thing's estimated to be 20 miles on throttle alone and up to 50 on pedal assist. If I got another one, I don't think I'd exceed 40 miles even fully on just throttle. See, like, these rocks up ahead, they're like embedded in. So these I can go around. Here in sections like this, you can't even really see which ones are embedded and which ones are loose. I recently put the seat that came with the bike back on, and so far it's been a lot better. I also replaced the throttle right here. This part snapped right off. Found one on Amazon for $9. It's also cheap plastic, but it works for now. Overall though, I'm really happy with the bike. Can't go over that fast when I'm sitting down. Hi. Pushing on straight. Dinosaurs in the canyon. Let's go look. Let's see. The tracks. Those were the dinosaur footprints. Hi. Alright, this is gonna be annoying to come back through. I have to go this way. Based on the tracks, it doesn't look like too many people have been this way to get past that house. If I had to guess, most people probably only go up to the dinosaur tracks. This looks like a quad or something has been through here, probably the park rangers. Alright, let's see where we are. Alright. So yeah, we started off down here. We've made it all the way up here. This trail goes on for a little bit. I might try going back this way. Maybe not though, I'll see. All this stuff over here looks like it's hiking only. So let's see. Let's go. Thank you. funny up this is gonna be. Also, this doesn't come off on camera, but this is very steep. It always sort of feels like I'm cheating because I get into all really deep into these parks, like to the point where there's not that many people because I have an electric bike. Boulders. Gotta say, they're really impressive, these tires. They're sometimes hitting these rocks at like 20 miles per hour. These are razor sharp rocks. The tires just bounce right off. I'm going slower today, so I'm going to conserve battery life because I'm not familiar with this area. Plus, I feel like more people are out in the places I usually ride. Yeah, this direction, this wasn't too bad. If I were to turn around, which I might, it would be too great. Let's check the map again. This looks like the end of this thing. So yeah, Sendero Balconies, if I'm reading that correctly. This is the trail I attempted from the other direction. Maybe I'll go back that way and hopefully it'll be downhill, but it doesn't look as flat as the trail I just took, which worries me a little bit. And that was Joe Johnston. This is the end. All right, let's attempt this direction. As long as it stays relatively flat, it's not too bad. It doesn't have too many boulders. The only concern is it getting too crazy. I'm like 5 or 6 miles into here. I'm pushing my way through like this section right here. This section is right through. Uphill. Oh man. I don't know if I should turn around. If I should just push through this one section. Let's see. Try to at least get to the end of, it's showing up on my phone as a somewhat wider trail. this might be okay downhill, but uphill. Maybe ride like something more powerful, like a dirt bike, but not this thing. Let's see if I can ride from here. Oh. This would be a terrible place to get a flat. So far from where I parked. Oh. This is really steep. This is what I have to push up to. This is almost vertical. After the electric drive, this would be a nightmare without it. All right, oh, I guess this section's uphill. Unfortunately, I may turn around at the end of it, so it'll be more fun and easier way back. Section. Definitely more of a hiking or pro-BM, like mountain bike trail. Oh, these little sections are fine. Let me check my map. Push it up this too. Almost to the end of what my phone is showing is like a more paved road. Just wanted to see what it looked like at the end. Let's see if I should go the other way. Let's get back to the van. So this is closed. I think this is the end. So I wonder if I go through here back. All right, GoPro is at 18% battery life. So I started off at 87. I feel like I've been complaining a lot this video, but really unimpressed with its battery life. They got like longer lasting battery from their store. And it seems marginally better than the regular battery. Like this run, the whole thing's discharged and it's, I don't know what it's been. I think it's been an hour. Hear something rustling around in the woods. Oh, so I'm gonna try to go back a different way. Hopefully this doesn't take me off the side of a canyon. But yeah, the battery life is not that great. I had a second one that I could use, but the GoPro too, it heats up like crazy. I hear animals sort of moving around the woods. This is a big drop. But on a lighter note, it's very beautiful here. So far, like it's mostly downhill, which is great. Especially with these rocks. I can let gravity take me down them instead of trying to force my way up them. It's a good choice to go the opposite way because I would have been going uphill 5 or 6 miles to get here. This way, this is a massive loop. At the end, I'll be around 12 or 13 miles, which for this kind of trail riding is quite a lot. At least for me. I was just talking about battery life on this GoPro, and I feel like I'm even more right now about it. I think I left my spare battery in the van, or I dropped it somewhere. So I'm at 12%, and I feel like I'm at the most interesting part of the trail, finally. 5 miles in, and the battery on this thing's probably gonna die at any moment now. I'm gonna go back the way I came. There's no point. Let's come back some other day. This is very steep. So I guess I'll see how long this battery lasts. Find out from 10% or whatever it's at now. This way. Oof. Oh. really steep. So.